HMD Global may have failed to put out a beastly Nokia smartphone of late, at least in my opinion. However, there's no denying the fact that most of the phones have at least looked pretty good. But what about the new Nokia C3? Well, the display is kind of old-fashioned and it has basic specifications, but more importantly, it does start at just 7,500 rupees. But does it do enough to give you a decent Android experience? Hi, I'm Royder and you're watching Gadgets 360 and this is my review of the new Nokia C3. Now, before I go ahead, don't forget to subscribe to our channel if you haven't and also smash that bell icon so you're the first to know whenever we have a new video. If the Nokia name wasn't enough nostalgia, the removable battery in the Nokia C3 should definitely bring back some memories. The entire back shell is a single piece of plastic which comes off so you can install the battery, SIM cards and a micro SD card. Now, there are two slots for nano SIM cards so you won't need any adapters. It's not too thick at 8.69mm and weighs a comfortable 184 grams. The Nokia C3 looks elegant thanks to the minimalistic back, which only has a tiny vertical camera module and a fingerprint sensor. The back panel doesn't attract fingerprints and offers good grip. The volume and power buttons are to the right, while the dedicated Google Assistant button is placed on the left. There's a headphone jack on the top and a micro USB port at the bottom. A fun fact is that there's no cutout for a speaker, and that's because Nokia C3 uses its earpiece as the loudspeaker. Because of its placement, there's little to no chance of it being blocked by your palm, and it also gets fairly loud as it faces you directly. Coming to the front of the phone, there's a 5.99-inch HD+ IPS display with toughened glass. Now, the design of the front also feels a bit nostalgic, but honestly, this is something that's best forgotten. Instead of a notch, the Nokia C3 has thick, old-fashioned borders on the top and bottom of the display, and relatively narrow ones on the sides. Now, this isn't a big complaint for an entry-level phone, but considering that its peers also have moved on to more modern designs, I think they could have done a better job. The display gets adequately bright though, and videos don't look too bad on it. The Nokia C3 is powered by a UniSoc processor, and the one I'm testing has 3GB of RAM and 32GB of storage, but you can also get the base variant which comes with 2GB of RAM and 16GB of storage. Now, the phone supports an FM radio too, but it requires a headset to be connected in order to work. Also, because it doesn't have a gyroscope and compass, you won't be able to see the direction you're facing in apps like Google Maps. Nokia C3 runs stock Android 10 with just the basic apps from Google pre-installed. The only third-party app is called My Phone from HMD Global, and it's for the after-sale support and device maintenance. You get some basic gestures in the Settings app, but that's the extent of the customization. The Google Assistant button should be handy if you're an avid user of it. It can't be remapped to launch any other app or functions though. Now, the Nokia C3 is not part of Google's Android One program, so you don't get that guarantee of at least 2 years of OS upgrades. But hey, at least it's not running Android 10 Go Edition like the Nokia One, right? Using Android on the Nokia C3 was a decent experience, but even with 3GB of RAM and bone stock Android, it wasn't the smoothest. Animations and multitasking caused some intermittent stutter and lag. The fingerprint sensor worked well, but the screen took a little longer than usual to wake up. Face recognition was also a bit slow to kick in and perform the authentication. Gaming performance wasn't too great either. Now, simple titles such as Skyforce Reloaded ran okay, but anything heavier really struggled to run well or deliver good graphics. The Nokia C3 doesn't have a very large battery, coming in at just 3040mAh in capacity. It performed very poorly in our HD video loop test, lasting for just 7.5 hours, which is one of the lowest times we've recorded in a long while. Now, with medium to light usage, I was able to get just about a full day's worth of battery life, but watching videos or gaming really drains the battery quickly. You only get a 5-watt power adapter in the box, but even when connected to a fast charger, I was only able to charge the battery to about 43% in an hour. The Nokia C3 has a single 8-megapixel rear camera and a 5-megapixel selfie camera. Now, autofocus is generally on the slower side and it tends to get worse in low light. The app offers basic shooting modes, but some of the common ones such as portrait mode are still missing. Unfortunately, image quality is quite underwhelming even in daylight. I found the dynamic range to be very weak, with most landscape shots I took exhibiting poor details and exposure. Close-ups were a bit better, but then again, textures generally looked flat and smoothened out. And low-light images turned out grainy with poor detail. Selfies generally had weak detail too, and exposure was all over the place when shooting during the day. In low light, most selfies were grainy and almost unusable. The Nokia C3 can shoot up to 1080p video, but I found the quality to be below average even during the day, and autofocus was also quite sluggish. Overall, the cameras in the Nokia C3 are quite disappointing, and sadly, I don't think they're even good enough for casual photography. I think it's pretty apparent by now that the Nokia C3 doesn't offer the best value for money, especially the 3GB variant that's priced at nearly 9,000 rupees. I think the Realme Narzo 10A or even the Narzo 20A, which we're currently testing, would be much better alternatives. Apart from a decent build quality and a clean Android experience, the Nokia C3 doesn't have enough going for it in its favor to justify this price. And the performance is middling, battery life is weak, cameras aren't good, and it looks a bit old-fashioned. Now, if you're on a really tight budget, then I think the Realme C11 is a good alternative at around 7,500 rupees. I mean, you lose the fingerprint sensor and performance is more or less the same, but hey, at least you get great battery life. So that is my review of the Nokia C3. Thanks for watching, and for all things tech, log on to gadgets360.com.